Good morning, everyone. I hope you all are safe at your home. This video is for the students of class 7th, subject English, and this is my revision video. In this video, we shall revise a lesson number 2, that is A Gift of Tuples, Poem to the Rebel, from our Honeycomb book, and a lesson number 2, The Noun Case, from our PC Runs grammar book. So let's start with our lesson number 2, that is A Gift of Tuples. Students, we have already read this chapter. I have given summary also. So in this video, we shall just have a look on the key points of the chapter just for the purpose of revising it. Ravi pulled Mridu. Wait, let me take off my slippers. So she set them out neatly. Mridu noticed a pair of large black slippers with marks of toes. So when Mridu reached Aunt Rukmani's house, on the entrance she noticed a pair of large black slippers with marks of toes. But seeing her, everybody was so excited that Ravi pulled Mridu to the backyard. Ravi took Mridu to the backyard. In the torn football lay a very small kitten lapping up milk from a half coconut shell. Meena and Ravi found it outside the gate. Meena told Mridu that it's a secret. Amma says Pati will leave for our Padu Mama's house if she knows we have a cat. Then Ravi and Meena shared their secret with Mridu that they had hidden a kitten in the backyard. And they asked her not to share the secret with anyone because if Pati would come to know about it, she would leave their house immediately. Then Ravi described the problems he had to face while keeping the kitten in the backyard. People always tell us to be kind to animals, but when we are, they scream, "Oh, don't bring that dirty creature here." And they call those animals dirty creatures. It was so hard to get little milk from kitchen. Pati saw him with a glass of milk in hand and looked suspiciously. So he had to drink most of the milk to make her believe. Pati asked the tumbler back. "Now we have to think of some other way to feed Mahindran," said Ravi. "Mahindran? This little kitty's name is Mahindran." Mridu was so impressed because it sounded like a real name. So what was the name of the kitten? The name of the kitten was Mahindran. Ravi told the kitten's full name is Mahindra Verma Pallava Punnai. Fine breed of cat, compares the fur of cat with lions. Ravi also questioned Mridu about the emblem of ancient Pallava kings. Mridu giggled. Giggled means laughed. She started laughing on Ravi's build-up story. Ravi asked Mridu, "Haven't you been to Mahabalipuram? Have you?" He told that when he last went there, he saw a statue of his tatas, 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 etc. Means he was continuously telling his own build-up story. Ravi concluded that this cat is a descendant of Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. Meena and Mridu exchanged their looks. Mahindran looked up alarmed. He was sharpening his claws on the edge of coconut shell. Screech! A weird sound came from the window. Mridu was startled. But the screeching did not stop and Mridu asked surprisingly, "What's the noise?" MP Punnai was frightened. Who is MP Punnai? The kitten. The kitten was scared. He bounced on a tray of red chilies, trying to hide beneath it. He tipped a few chilies over himself. Ravi told that that's Lali learning to play violin. He compared master's singing like a train whizzing on and on while Lali's train is drilling. Three of them looking through the window, Lali was awkwardly holding her violin, eyes glazed with concentration. Now music master, he was mostly bald, a fringe of oiled black hair falling around his ears and wore an old-fashioned tuft. He played a few notes. Lali stumbled behind him. Amma, came a wail. Wail means cry or sound from the gate. Amma, oh. Ravi was asked to send away the beggar. Pati explained Tapi that the beggar has been coming here every day the past week. Mridu and Nina followed Ravi. The beggar made himself comfortable already in the garden and Ravi asked the beggar to go away. The beggar pleaded again and raised his voice. Amma, oh Amma, Rukumani replied Ravi, tell him there is nothing left in the kitchen. Beggar said, I will go. Only let me have rest here under this tree. The sun is so hot, the tar has melted on the road. My feet are already blistered. Mridu whispered to Meena and Ravi that he has no money to buy chappals. Went inside the house to get the chappals. Gave those black chappals. Now, listening to the beggar, Mridu was feeling very bad for the beggar. Then she whispered to Meena and Ravi that he had no money to buy chappals. We should give him something. So, she gave those chappals which she saw on the entrance of the Rukumani's house. She went and gave those black chappals to the beggar. The beggar was really very happy to get a new pair of chappals. So, that was a gift of chappals for the beggar. Music master looked for his chappals. Now it was the time for music master to leave. He started looking for his chappals. Told that they were expensive and brand new. And when he was not able to find those chappals, he told everyone that they were very expensive and they were new pair of chappals. Lali went inside to tell Rukumani the whole scene. As Lali was not a part of this, so she didn't know anything. She went inside and told Rukumani the whole scene. Pati said so many vendors came to the door. Rukumani questioned three of them. Mridu shivered and told Rukumani that they gave the chappals to the beggar. Rukumani brought Gopu Mama's hardly worn chappals and music teacher was happy. Then what happened? When Rukumani questioned three of them, Mridu was very scared. She told the whole scene to Rukumani. Then Rukumani went inside the house and she brought Gopu Mama's hardly worn chappals and gave it to the music teacher. The music teacher was very happy to get a new pair of chappals, but he was not showing it because he wanted to hide his greed. So this was your lesson. Okay, now we shall revise our poem number 2, that is The Rebel. The poem The Rebel describes the character of a rebel, a person who does not conform to the norms of the society. The rebel is described as a person who would contradict others in order to be different. The character of the rebel in the poem is not based on a political activist but seems to be a character sketch of a young adolescent trying to be different in the society. All the instances in the poem are repetitive affirmation of this fact. If a rebel sees a group of people with short hair, he would let his hair grow long. On seeing others with long hair, the rebel would cut short his hair. Seeing everybody talk during the lesson, the rebel would become absolutely mute. On realizing that everybody is silent, the rebel would create a disturbance. Similarly, on various such issues, the rebel would be seen contradicting others and doing things that no one would be doing. He would refuse to wear the uniform when the others would be wearing it, praise the dogs when in the company of cat lovers, appreciate the sun on rainy days and rains on the sunny days. He would do just anything but not what others are doing. Means he has to do always opposite. So this was your poem, that is The Rebel. Now we shall revise our lesson number 2 of grammar, that is the noun case. So, before understanding noun case, we should know what is noun and what are its types. A noun is a word used to name a person, animal, place, thing, emotion, and an abstract idea. Or in short, it is a naming word. For example, book, pencil, bag, newspaper, bucket, these all are nouns. Types of nouns: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun. Okay. Now we shall discuss noun case. The case of a noun tells us about the position of that noun in a sentence. Cases are of three types. There are three types of noun case: nominative case, objective case, which are also known as accusative case, and possessive case, which are also known as genitive case. So first of all, what are nominative case? When the noun stands as the subject of a verb, it is said to be in the nominative case. Means when the noun is subject in the sentence, that noun is in nominative case. For example, Rashmi lost her ring. In the sentence, Rashmi is subject in the sentence. So Rashmi is in nominative case. Objective case, when the noun stands as the object of a verb, it is said to be in the objective case. For example, Rashmi lost her ring. In the sentence, ring is object in the sentence, so ring is an objective case. So basically, if the noun is subject in the sentence, that is nominative case. If the noun is object in the sentence, that is an objective case. Third one is possessive case. The possessive case is also known as the genitive case. A noun or pronoun used to show possession is said to be in the possessive case. A noun in the possessive case answers the question whose. For example, is that your brother's bat? If I ask the question whose bat, the answer will be brother's bat, brothers. So the word brothers is in possessive case. And you can also recognize that possessive case are made or are formed by adding apostrophe and s, or only apostrophe in case of plural nouns. So now your homework is you have to revise lesson number 2, A Gift of Chapels, poem 2, The Rebel, and lesson number 2, The Noun Case of Grammar. On the basis of revising them, you have to do the assignment given on EdQuark site in homework column. There is one more important information for you. The day when you get revision video on YouTube, on that day you will get assignment on EdQuark site. After that, for 2 days, there will be no videos on YouTube channel. For 2 days, one day you have to do assignment, and next day will be given to you for test, which you will get on EdQuark site.